Hello everyone and welcome back. It's Chuck Thunder and we're going to show you another tutorial here on how to get the Steam Engineer job. We have to log into two characters for this one, not because that's what you need to do to get the job, but because, well, it'll explain. So first we're going to log into the character that wants the Steam Engineer job. Chuck Thunder wants the Steam Engineer job because Chuck Thunder is a caster and also needs to up his management skills. So the Steam Engineer job has particularly good skills for casting and also helps. So casting is a favorite job, and so is, oh gosh, well, is management favorite or is management expert? Well, in either case, the things that you're focusing on here, let's bring it up real quick. Steam Engineer job. Management is expert, navigation is favored, casting is favored, so, and all minerals, all the stuff that my tune wants altogether. So that's the character that needs the Steam Engineer job. Now, I've gone and gotten the Steam Engineer job before with my main character, Charles Thunder, and I vaguely remember how to do it, so I figured, you know what, this is an opportunity to teach some people how to do it, because it's one of those skills that you want. Management, whether or not it's something that your character uses regularly for its production skills. If you're doing any production, management is great because it helps make great successes out of your jobs, as well as also it's super important for it's super important for skills on boats and stuff, because your boats on your ships need particular levels of skill. So like just as an example, I'll show you my ship. This ship has no skills, no original skills, but I do have a ship here, my Thunder God ship, and my Gift Frigate, originally modified frigate, and my Aid Cab that have all these different skills on them. Let's look at the Thunder God ship real quick. It has High Lookout, Galley, and Aid's Cabin. In order for these to be active skills on your ship, they're kind of like passive skills, and sometimes they're not always passive, sometimes they're things you click. You need to have management and navigation skill of a certain requirement. So getting your management skill up higher quicker means you get faster access to these. And here's the one that requires 4 and 4 for management navigation. Here's one that requires 5 for management. Gosh, that's not too loud. And Aid's Cabin requires 8 and 7. So that's why it's important to have your management skill very high and quickly. So Chuck Thunder, which is Charles Chuck Thunder, needs it for his casting, his management, and some of the ships that he wants to have. So here we are, the business mediator. So, wondering, okay, where do you start? Well, one of the first things to do to get the Steam Engineer job is a certain quest line. All the way down in Cape Town. All the way down here. Okay? I sailed down here with both of my main teams. Down the bottom of Cape Town. I didn't need to have the boat down here for this, but I do need to have the person that completed the quest. He needs to pull the quest because he has the ability to pull it. So let's take things step by step. First things first. Chuck Thunder cannot pull the quest because he doesn't have the required quest requirements. I'll show you. If I look at the quest here, the business mediator, it's called Troubled Casting Workshop. It requires already a management skill of 5, navigation level of 3, and the arms one is not as important in the picture at all. The arms level 3. Not even Charles Thunder has this, so it's not important. You really want to make things happen, you get some control to get there, but you don't need arms required to. But you don't need it. You need management skill and navigation skill at the very least to get the quest. So, only Charles Thunder can pull this because Chuck Thunder just doesn't have the base to do it. So that's the first thing. So I have fleeted up with Chuck Thunder, and when Charles Thunder pulls the quest, it becomes passed along to Chuck Thunder as a quest that he also will receive credit for when he completes it. So I've gone and accepted the quest. If you don't find the quest, you have to use QMPs until it pops. Just make sure you go in there with at least two of those three requirements of Management 5 and Navigation 3. So first and foremost thing. Second, the quest, I'm not even done, I'm walking away. The quest requires some extra clicking from the business mediator. So after you've accepted the quest, talk to the business mediator again. He says, oh, so you're going to help? I appreciate it. I would like you to deliver 200 bags of chrome ore to the casting workshop supervisor in Manchester, that's up in London. CMG's troubled due to the bad refining of efficiency of stainless steel. If you could also give him some advice, I'm sure that he'd be happy. He will be happy too. Well then, we are counting on you. Okay? So you don't need to talk to him anymore, but I just did anyways. And you would need to buy chrome ore for the market keeper. Let's go over here to the market keeper. Oh wait, can we talk to him? Chrome ore is not here. We have copper ore, iron ore, tin ore, but no chrome ore. So you're probably wondering, well, what the heck? Well, I already went and bought chrome ore. I had somebody gift it to me, thankfully, but you can usually find chrome ore in the company shops in one of the major cities, and you can buy it in advance. Be sure to buy it before you go to Manchester. You don't have to buy it now, if you don't want to, but if you have access to buying it down here in Cape Town, you should. Otherwise, go and quickly buy it from the company shop. It'll be expensive, but worth it, so you don't have to do the other part of this, which, if you don't want to go to the company shops, and you do want to get access to the chrome ore from the market keeper here, you'll need to invest into the city of Cape Town. 8.5 million ducats. That you're not going to get there with any amount of ease. You can only usually donate around, like, what, 30 to 60,000 ducats at a time? That's way too many times that you're going to have to either put in a request to do it again, using those items that allow you to do it multiple times, or having to port hop. Totally not worth it just to get access to chrome ore until you are somebody who wants to go buy chrome ore and bring it back and sell it for a profit. So, yeah, go ahead, do the $8.5 million investment of investing in this town over time, and then unlock chrome ore. And sure, buy stacks of chrome ore whenever you can, bring them back, and you can sell them for a profit and make your $8.5 million back. So, sure, but right now, we're just trying to get this demon in your quest, so we need 200 chrome ore, so I went and bought it. So, Charles Thunder is holding the 200 chrome ore. Chuck Thunder doesn't need to. Charles Thunder has the quest, and Charles Thunder's going to complete the quest. Chuck Thunder's going to get credit for completing the quest. That's it. So, now that we have our 200 chrome ore, you either bought it from the company shop, or you bought it from the market keeper, or somebody gave it to you, like they did for me. We are going to... First, let's take my road request stuff here. We are going to get in a boat. We're going to make sure we're stocked up. For the majority of the time, we'll be able to sail all the way there. Straight. We're going to have us auto sail to Manchester. Now we can't reach there. Auto sailing, so we're just going to go to Cabo Verde. We'll switch over to our other account. Pop off here. Chuck. And while we're following, let's go ahead and put our caution, fishing, fidelity on. And we'll Chuck Thunder, Charles Thunder, the same thing. Caution, fishing. Now you might be wondering, why am I fishing? You know, well, it's probably because I'm going to give all my fish that I get from both of these characters to Chuck Thunder. Because then Chuck Thunder is going to need to use that to convert them to the actual fish commodity so we can sell them. So we'll convert sardines to fish. Doing that is a way to grind management. Remember, I don't know if I talked about this before in other videos, but grind management is doing some sort of production skill while at sea. If you're doing production while in cities, you won't gain any management experience. You will get management experience only if you are doing the productions while sailing, physically moving. So, something to focus on with our characters as we are sailing. We don't have to wait this minute, but once we get up there and we get this team in the job, we're in the job. That's what we're going to do. Now, we aren't going to do much else other than sail there. So once you're done sailing there, then we're going to pick it up and talk more about the quest. So right now we're just kind of auto sailing a portion of the way up, and then we're going to get to Manchester because that's the next part of the quest. The quest line says, see if you could bring him some advice into the merchant. double check. So in case you guys are curious, on the Blogspot website, here is the explanation of where I'm getting this all from. Talk to the business mediator again to open the quest window. Get your Chrome. You could buy from all sorts of different options. You can collect Chrome from the Gulf of Bothnia. That's another option from the boulders landmark in the middle of the map, but you need R13. They act like R13 collection is enough. Well, good luck getting there. And then we're going to deliver it to the Manchester factory. All right? So we're going to cut it here, and we're going to rejoin the recording right back when we reach Manchester. See you then. Hello, everyone. We made it to Manchester. So here we are. We're going to hop out into town. So just as a quick, I'm going to turn off the music in this place. It doesn't quite fit the rest of the game's theme of music, if you ask me. Alright, so Chuck Thunder is going to pursue Trollsong. So just a quick recap. Oh, I've got to turn off the sound for this one too. Jeez. Alright, so we are now in Manchester. Quick recap, we went to Cape Town, we brought 200 ore with us to Manchester after accepting the quest titled Troubled Casting Workshop Supervisor, where we talked to the business mediator down there to get the job, and then we had to talk to him again, and then he told us to come here with 200 bags of chrome ore and go to the Casting Workshop Supervisor of Manchester. So, time to find this guy. Now, if I remember correctly, we have to go to the factory, so we're going to teleport there with this. And we're going to go to the factory. Pretty sure it's here. And now we've got to find the casting workshop supervisor. So there's the handicrafts workshop supervisor. Looks like it's going to be cooking. Textile casting looks like it's going to be back here. There he is. We are here in this manufacturing area. Talk to him. Oh, you brought me this much chrome ore? Thank you. I see. So if we change this process like that, the steam engine will operate more efficiently. Oh, you're right. You seem to be knowledgeable and talented enough to be a leading steam engineer. I must ask of the guild to certify this. And then it says, gather necessary quest information, check the quest stream, quest completed. You have delivered 200 bags. And now we just gotta hand it in. So, there you go. That's how you get the quest. The real problem is gonna be, though, is where do you hand it in? And for us, handing it in will likely mean going to Seville and talking to the barkeep. That's going to be my guess. I'm going to test that out. You guys don't need to see that on screen, but once you do complete that, you will get the steam engineer job, and you can change into it from there. I don't know that you'll be able to just immediately become the steam engineer at the end, necessarily, but you will be able to... while we're here, you will be able to take on the job and then stay in that job while you grind your management and navigation skills. So I think this episode might as well just stop here. Don't think you need to see me doing the handing of the quest. This is just the completion task of the quest. So I want to thank everybody for stopping by. This is Chuck Thunder. Thanks for watching, and be sure to like and subscribe. Take it easy.